turn your still photos into animations with three easy tricks, all on the PowerDirector app. And if you're looking for a similar tutorial for the PC version, go watch this tutorial. This first trick shows an illusion of buildings moving in different directions. It's a fun trick to use if you want to turn your normal city photos into Inception-esque optical illusions. The first thing we need to do is choose a photo to use for this effect. The easiest type of photo to do this effect on is one where the buildings look like they're at an eye level or a face-to-face angle with the camera. It should have clear lines that show where one building stops and another starts. You'll also want to think about the aspect ratio of your photo. If you're posting your finished project on a short form platform like Instagram Stories or Reels or YouTube Shorts, you'll want to find a photo that is 9:16, whereas for a long form video on YouTube, it should be 16:9. Open up your photo in the PowerDirector app, then drag and drop the clip onto the second track, leaving the main track blank. In the editing window, pull on the photo to zoom in order to leave room for the animation. Next, go into the Mask tab. Tap the Parallel option and adjust the mask to fit just one of your buildings in your picture. Tap the Back button to go back to the main menu, then tap Duplicate. Drag and drop your duplicated clip onto the third track. Highlight the second clip by tapping on it, then move the mask over to cover your next building. Repeat these steps as many times as you need to cover each of the buildings in your clip. Now we'll add keyframes to make each building move in different directions. Highlight your first clip, then tap Transform Keyframe. Tap on the diamond, then adjust the photo in the preview window to wherever you want your first frame to start. Since the buildings are moving either up or down along the screen, slide the photo to either the top or bottom. Drag the playhead to the end of the clip, then drag the photo in the opposite direction, either up or down. A keyframe diamond will automatically show up on your clip. Repeat the steps for each of your clips, making sure to adjust the photo in the opposite direction as the clips neighboring each other. Once you're done, export your completed video and remember to produce in 4K. We're going to take this clip and import the video you just completed onto a timeline in a new project. Click Transform Keyframe, then click on the diamond to set a keyframe. Zoom in and twist the video diagonally in the preview window. There's no set way to do this, so you can move and twist your video in whatever way looks most interesting to you. Drag your playhead to the end of the timeline, then zoom out or twist diagonally in the opposite direction. This effect is done using a little bit of stop motion magic. Take a series of photographs. They don't need to be perfectly aligned to the precision that goes into a complete stop motion video. As long as they're roughly related to the photo that came before it, the AI in PowerDirector can turn it into a video. Upload your photos in the right order on the main track. Adjust the duration of each photo to be 5 frames. You can either do this by looking at the timeline and pulling at the end of your photo clip, or you can tap into duration and adjust for 0.5. If you preview your full project, it'll look a little bit like stop motion. Export this, then start a new project by tapping on the AI anime shortcut in the launcher. Select the clip you just exported, then allow the AI to process and export a full AI anime video. This next effect combines both the parallax effect and a Dolly zoom. A parallax effect occurs when the object in your foreground moves at a different speed than your background. A Dolly zoom usually occurs with a physical camera when you move towards or away from your main subject, while simultaneously zooming in the opposite direction with your camera. Basically, it creates a visual warp for the viewer. So to start your edit, you'll need to choose a photo that has a clear foreground and background. Upload your photo onto the timeline, then use the preview window to zoom and move to the right or left a little bit. This will leave some room for the movements you're about to keyframe in. Tap on the duplicate button to create a copy, then move the duplicated clip to the second track. Highlight the duplicated clip by tapping on it, tap into Cut Out, then select Remove Background. This will leave a cutout of just your main subject in your foreground. Go to Transform Keyframe, then tap on the diamond to set your first keyframe. Move your playhead to the end of the clip, then zoom into the cutout by adjusting it in the preview window to look bigger. Make sure that this cutout is fully hiding the original foreground subject in the main track. Now tap to highlight the clip on the main track, then go into Transform Keyframe. tap on the diamond, move your playhead to the end of the timeline, then zoom out, once again adjusting in the preview window. This will create a visual warp, making your foreground look as if it is zooming in and your background zooming out. Which effect was your favorite? Leave a comment down below letting us know. If you're looking for more cool tutorials to follow, check out our channel and subscribe. See you next time.